Have you ever wondered if you could 3D print just using the power of the sun? Today, we're going to be pushing the limits of solar energy by attempting to run a 3D printer with a single 200 watt solar panel and a portable power station. So, can this setup generate enough power to keep our printer running smoothly, or are we going to hit some bumps along the way? Join me as we set up the equipment and see if it is truly possible to harness the sun's energy for 3D printing. Let's find out. So this is the ALLPOWERS R1500 power station, and it uses LiFePO₄ batteries, and it's got a capacity of 1152 watt hours. That's a lot. So we're actually going to be doing some math to see how long we could run the printer just on this alone. Now, what's cool about this one is it does have an 1800 watt pure sine wave inverter with a peak power of 3000 watts. Now, the sine wave inverters are important because it keeps the power proper. So like if you try to use a TV with a non-sine wave inverter, you would just get waves all over the TV showing that the electrical current isn't constant. Another cool feature about this one is you could actually use it as a UPS backup. And they claim that it'll do a 15 millisecond backup time. So if power goes out within 15 milliseconds, it'll kick on and start giving you power to what you need. This particular one can do up to 650 watts of max solar input, but we're not gonna be going anywhere near that today. Today, we're just gonna be using a single 200 watt solar panel. Now, there is something to know about solar panels is that while they are rated for 200 watts, that doesn't mean we're actually going to get 200 watts. There's a lot of factors that come into play on whether or not you're gonna get close to 200. Honestly, we're not even gonna see close to 200. I think we'll probably see like 135 watts. Well, now that the intro on this thing is out of the way, let's get outside and set this thing up and start using the power of the sun.
So setting up this solar panel is really easy. It folds up super nice and all you have to do is undo a couple straps, undo the Velcro, and it just folds open, and it's even got built-in stands to hold itself up. Now, the stands aren't the greatest, but they do do the job, and you know what? It is what it is.
All right, so right now, with the solar panel set up into the sun, we're bringing in 127 watts. Which, like I said, is way less than the 200, but that's kind of what I figure with these. In peak output, I would expect probably like 135. I could be wrong. Let me know down in the comments. I'm not an expert with this stuff, but I do like it. Right now, we're at actually 130. Let me try cleaning off the panels here just a little bit and see if we can't get a little bit more out of that. I cleaned it off. We're still sitting at about 123 watts. So let's get some printers plugged into this thing and see how much they actually use. All right. Back to the garage where it's nice and cooler. All right, so let's go ahead and plug into the portable power station. Let there be light. All right, so just with the printer on, we're drawing about 25 watts. And let's go start a benchy. So now that we're completely plugged into solar power, let's go ahead and get a benchy rolling on this thing. We're going to be using the Bambu Labs X1 Carbon. We're going to use the textured plate with some good old PLA. We'll just slice one of the built-in ones here, benchy, UJMS, and go. Hopefully you can see, but right now with the warm-up procedure, we're drawing about 45, 50 watts and still well under the 133 watts. All right, so now we're back to printing and we're sitting at 66 watts, 68 watts being used. Man, that's actually not a lot. Let's turn on the A1 mini and get another benchy going. And let's see if we can push this thing. Cause right now we got plenty of headway to work with. All right, now we have another benchy going on the A1. It's gonna do its setup and get going and whatnot. And then we'll check back to see how much we're using. Ooh, turning on the A1
has definitely spiked things here. We're sitting at 230 watts and now we're coming back down. So now we're going past the limit of the 200 watt solar panel. But I think once it settles in and starts going, we'll be back under that 131, hopefully. All right, so now we got both printers actually printing and we're using a little more than what we're bringing in on solar. So really, we could actually use this for quite a while just on the solar with one printer, and we could actually get away with doing two printers for quite a while because we're still bringing in like a lot of the power via the solar to recharge this battery. All right, and so there we have it. We have a Benchy that was printed with the power of the sun, kind of. I mean, really, it was powering the printer. But not only just this Benchy, but on the A1 Mini, we also printed another one to test out the power of that portable power station.
So there we have it. Two Benchies printed with the power of the sun, kind of, right? And using solar power and some batteries. It's all really cool. And what's nice is with that setup, you can do off-site or off-grid printing really easily. You know, if that battery pack was fully charged and we just ran the one printer, we could get probably about 16 hours worth of printing with it, I think. I'll have to double check the math. I'll put it right here. But yeah, that's a long time to be able to print with just a portable power pack. I think that's really cool. And if you think this video is cool, make sure you hit that like button and comment. Let me know if there's any crazy ideas I should do here in the future. And while you're at it, subscribe. This is Adam from the Rad Dad Print Lab. I'll see you next time.